just got a new house, gotta hide the skeletons in the closet and keep them there, really trying to forget about them. They tell me God watching over me, I don't doubt it. But I can see him getting tired of me sinning and wilding. Don't know what to do with myself these days. Young rich nigga, I done fell in love with the bank. But all this money don't rip me of my pain. But everywhere I go, I can make it precipitate rain. Fucked up, I did. Fucked up, I am. Calm down, I can't. Shit, here we go again. Abandoning all ships, it's about to go down. No Titanic, Titanic. There's a lot going on in my head right now, but I manage.
Hello and welcome back to another Diecast unboxing review. Before we start, if you guys want this full disclaimer, I'd recommend go checking out the Kyle Larson Hendrick Motorsports test car from 2022. If you can tell by my voice, I'm losing my voice. I've gotten sick recently. But more on that, go check out the Kyle Larson 2022 test car review, 164. But moving on to the video, I am joined by RD.
Yo.
And let's get on to the review. This is one that he's been waiting for me to do. It is on AJ Allmendinger's number 16 Hyper Ice. I think that I'm saying that right. Hyper Ice number 16 car for Colleague Racing. It is his Indianapolis Roval race win, or Indianapolis Road Course race win, whatever you want to call it, the Roval or the Road Course. I do not have the trading card that came with it, but anyway, moving on. Start with the left side of the car. We've got Goodyear right above the left front tire in black. We've got the NASCAR Cup Series logo right above it, or right above, right on the left side of the car. You got the NASCAR race car logo. You got these black and gray stripes going up in some kind of slants or whatever. I don't know what kind of livery design this is. Someone ought to correct me in the comments on what kind of livery design this is. Got the black 16 with a white and black outline. For Colleague Racing, you've got AJ Allmendinger right above the window net. And then I don't know what all these individual sponsors are right here, so I apologize about that. You've got leaf filters, or leaf filter. I forgot what they are. And then you've got, I don't know what these two sponsors are down here. I apologize. I'd have to get a better picture. I'd have to look at a better picture of the car, which I do not have on hand right now. You've got high.
I can tell you about the filter.
No, that's fine. If you got Hyper Ice, their Hyper Ice logo right above the right rear, left rear tire, excuse me. And as my camera loses focus, you've got tire marks right behind the left front, the left rear tire, from obviously making contact with whoever he made contact with in that race. I watched the race live, but I don't remember much. I just remember the end of the race when Chase Briscoe got his penalty when Allmendinger forced him off the track. Which I believe is complete bullshit, but that's just my opinion, part of my language. You've got Hyper Ice, you got the Chevy logo, the Camaro taillights, number 16 below the left rear taillights. ZL1, Camaro ZL1. And then moving on to the right side, you got leaf filter. The Hyper Ice logo. You've got some scrapes right here on the left rear quarter panel. Oh, and you got and the American excuse me, the American ethanol fuel area is on the right side of this car instead because of them pitting the other way at Indianapolis when they do the Roval there, which I think is better than doing the course? That they did that. They do it at Watkins Glen as well. Hyper Ice, you got 16 with a white and black outline. You got these gray and black gray, black, and white stripes going across the side. NASCAR race car, NASCAR Cup Series, and then Goodyear right above the right front tire. That's in black. You got Allmendinger right above the car? Yes. You got AJ Allmendinger right above the right side window. On the front, you've got the white 16 right below the right front headlight. You've got tape on the grill from where he had tape put on. I like that bit of detail. The ZL1 logo, you got the Chevy logo, you got the Colleague Racing logo right below the left front headlight. You've got Hyper Ice logo on the hood. The colors on this car are white, black, and gray. And then for the roof, you got the yellow number 16 with a black and white outline. And then you've got the Hyper Ice logo on right next to the number 16 on the roof as well. Nothing on the rear deck lid. I think they could have put a Hyper Ice logo on there, but that's just my opinion. But I guess we got to keep it accurate to the race win. Actually, I don't even know. Somebody correct me if this is for sure accurate to the race win, as my camera keeps losing focus. Well, that's because it's a lot easier to add more detail to the 124s. Somebody let me know in the comment section of this. I would really like to know, is this car accurate to the race win? Somebody please let me know in the comment section down below. This is an exclusive to NASCAR Authentics as well. So if you happen to find this, I recommend picking it up, especially if you're looking for a Colleague Racing Cup Series car, because this is like the only one we've got. And especially if you're a fan of both Colleague Racing or AJ Allmendinger as a whole, I can definitely say I didn't like him this past year in the Xfinity Series, but that's just me. I think he's driven like a bit of a dick. But then again, I did like him when I was younger, when I watched him in the 47 car. But that's just me. I think it's great that he's coming back to the Cup Series next year full-time. Yep, full-time in 2023. He will be racing for Colleague, and my guess is in the number 16 car. I got nothing else to add. This race in particular was absolute bullshit, but that's just my opinion, pardon my French. But, like I said, we're all entitled to our own opinions. But I think that this is still definitely a great diecast. If you're a fan of Colleague Racing, speaking of Colleague Racing, Matt Colleague has actually responded to me on social media before. And Matt Colleague, might I add, Matt Colleague is a really nice guy. Really, really great guy. I greatly appreciate that he's responded to me on social media when he doesn't even have to. That's really nice that he takes time for his fans or fans of his team. And I think that they are a great organization. And I do see great things coming in the near future for Colleague Racing. And hopefully maybe one of these years they will get a Cup Series championship. But I guess we'll have to wait and see. As to what the future holds. I think this is a really great diecast. Like I said, if you're a fan of AJ Allmendinger, fan of Colleague Racing, or Matt Colleague, or whatever, or if you're a fan of Hyper Ice, somebody let me know in the comment section, what is Hyper Ice? Because I'd love to know. But anyway, like I said, if you guys are looking to pick this up, or if you guys find this, I recommend picking this up. This is a NASCAR Authentics exclusive. It's the first Colleague, it's like the only Colleague Racing car that we've gotten in 164 from the Cup Series, at least. I believe the 31 car of Justin Haley from 2022 got canceled this year, unfortunately. But other than that, like I said, this is a great diecast, and I got nothing else to add. RD, you're an Allmendinger fan. You're a Colleague Racing fan, so I guess I'm gonna send it off to you. Go ahead. Alright, well, if y'all went on to like the video, like rating would of course be awesome. Also, let me know if you guys already have this car, if you plan on picking this one up. Let me know down in the comment section down below. Links to both RD's channel and my other good friends and stuff like that, links to their channels will all be in the description. Link to my Instagram will be in the description below as well. And I will see you guys in the next video. Peace.
Seasons changing like the wind. Where it starts is where it ends. Life was better with